Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to solve yet another problem that I have. I have a 1997 Dodge 2500 12 valve diesel, which sounds great, except for, oh really, it only has an 8-foot bed. And typically an 8-foot bed will be right in the sweet spot of what you want. But in this particular case, I got to haul around 20-foot sticks of tubing. So I do have a couple other projects I wanted to do with that tubing. One of them, I want to build some sliders for the taco because I don't want to take it off-road without them, because it'll be dinging up the body and I don't want to do that. I also, in the Wagoneer, one project I do have later on is that I do want to put like a small like cage inside. If I ever roll that big joker, we're pretty much dead. All it is glass. It's just going to tip over, and I would like to have at least a little bit of protection for the family. So, how are we going to fix this problem? Well, I could pull a trailer, which I do have access to a 20-foot trailer, and that would be sweet. I could use my utility trailer, take all the sides off, but I'm still hanging out the back. So why don't I just build something to make the truck be able to handle a 20-foot stick of tubing? So this is what we're going to do. All right, so most people call them headache racks. Some people might call this a ladder rack, but what we're going to do is put a small plate right here. We're going to weld weld something all up to here, all the way across and back down. Should be really simple, really easy. And hell, I got a welder, I got a cutter, I got a saw, and I'm pretty sure I got some spare steels laying around somewhere. So let's go hop into the garage, see what we got. Let's go. All right, I think we found something. Once again, network rack to the rescue. Now, I have said in a couple of other videos that I do get these things from work. Basically, I go dumpster diving. They get ready to throw them out. It could either be a old model. In this particular case, it was an HP. We don't usually have our competitor stuff in the lab, so they were wanting to get rid of it. It's good steel, you just gotta spend the time to tear it down and to be able to use it. So now, we're gonna use it. So I'm gonna go take some measurements, I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna do a quick rough sketch on the table, and then we're gonna cut, cut, chop, chop, weld, weld. And then we're gonna do a small little up, down, over, and back down again. So, all right, I think I got it all figured out now. So basically it's just gonna be 2 foot for the upper struts. We're gonna have 2 foot plates to be able to bolt that down to the bed. So it's 2 foot, 2 foot, and then 6 foot across. Very simple, very easy. I don't think I'll be putting that much weight on it. Probably don't even need gussets, but I might put some up there anyway. Just don't hold me accountable if I don't put them up there, because that means I didn't feel like it at the time. These are only a couple sticks of the DOM and 20-foot sticks. If it's good quality. The price was a lot better than I have in the past. So we might go back and get some more once I start doing the cage. But these two sticks will be able to do what we need to do for right now. So I'm gonna use my beautiful toy down there. All right. Oh yes, look at that. Isn't she beauty? She's a beauty. Yeah, that's a fine tools that I picked up a little while ago, and it cuts steel pretty much like it's a hot knife through butter. Fantastic. The only problem is, where's your safety glasses? All right, I'm gonna go ahead and cut these up. I need 4 2-footers and 1 6-footer. And then when you come back, I should have everything ready to grind and get ready for welding. All right, I think I'm good. I got everything cut. I got everything ground. I got good, clean steel. That's one thing you always gotta remember. Just hit it with a wire brush, hit it with a flap wheel. Something to clean off all the grot and stuff like that that's on the steel. Good clean steel welds very well. So this is what we got. So I kind of want to make this removable. So I just got some C-clamps holding this thing together, but she is in there nice and sturdy. So I got one plate on that side, one plate on that side. And what I did was actually ground down the tip of that, because what we're gonna do is actually try to follow the body line and then just weld that in place. So what I'm gonna do right now is actually just gonna tack these in place, get some pretty fat tacks in there. And then I'm gonna put one on top, line that up, put some fat tacks on that. I'm gonna let it cool for a little bit, and then I'm gonna take the C-clamps off, I'm gonna take it to the bench, and then we're just gonna weld it all the way in. We're probably gonna put a lot of heat in it, so it'll probably warp, but it's okay, because that's not something I'm gonna leave up here all the time, but it will be something that I can use whenever I need to haul 20-foot sticks, because I only got an 8-foot bed.
I'm not exactly gonna put my jacket on, but I'm at least put my gloves on.
I'm gonna help turn the gas on.
Cool. All right, where's my plate? All right, I think once we weld that up, and maybe I might put a brace or two in there, maybe one going straight up. That should keep it nice and sturdy. But yeah, put it down on the bench, get some airflow, because I'm sure this is some sort of galvanized stuff and I don't want to die. So get some airflow and we'll get that welded up. Might mess up the paint of the truck if I weld it here. All right, let's get that done and see what it does. All right. So I'm getting ready just to weld this up. Everything should be lined up. Gotta get my jacket on, even though it's blazing hot in here, but it's okay. I'm gonna do a quick weld over here. I'll do one up here, and then we'll go down there, and then we'll bounce around so we don't overheat the product and warp it out really bad. Well, let's see. Let's see what we got. I don't know. I think for what it's going to be used for the first time around, I think we're good to go. If I go up there and it starts to swing a little bit, I might put some gussets on it, or maybe in a ratchet strap, just trying to cross triangulate it or whatever. But I think this will be good for what I'm going to be doing it with. You know, I'm just going to put that up there. So let's put it on and I'll show you what we're going to do as a finished product.
All right, we're pretty much done for what we're actually going to do. Pretty happy with it, and this is what it looks like. So we got our rack up front, which is going to keep the stuff off the cab, I hope. And then we also have an extend-a-bed that will take care of the back half of the pipe. So I don't think I'm going to paint it. I don't think I'm going to do anything else to it. So I'm just going to leave it raw. It seems to be pretty sturdy. I don't know how strong that top piece is. I might have to strengthen that up a little bit if it starts to bend. For what it's doing, I think it'll be okay. Two pipes, or two tubes. It's got a little bit of weight to it, but it's not huge. So we should be okay. If nothing else, I will diagonal it and get it closer to the edge so it'll give it a little bit better support. But as for now, I think we're in good shape. Hopefully tomorrow I'll go and pick that up. But in case you were wondering about the sturdiness of this thing, take a look at this. All right. So it's not too awful bad. For what it is, I think we're okay. A couple things I did notice this. This is pretty much galvanized. I was holding my breath and also had the fans going. Try to get the fumes out of there because this stuff is pretty dangerous. One way you can actually figure that out is when you get that. Yeah, I did not scrape it off all the way there, so it not a good time. But you know, if you stay smart about it and you protect yourself, you should be okay. You can tell that you get pretty good penetration when you get good heat penetration all the way through. Pretty much everywhere you have, you got some more of the galvanized stuff, but I think I got enough heat in it. It should be good. She's nice and warm still, but she should be strong enough for what I need to do. Worst case, what I can do is put a 2x4 on top of this to keep this thing from bending and then strap it all down. Hey, I'm back. And I got my tube and also my little rack did pretty darn well. See, still being held on with C-clamps so I can take it off. But it rode down the road just fine. It did wiggle a little bit, but it worked out. All right, so this was just a quick project that I wanted you guys to see. Hopefully you learned a little bit from it. The biggest thing that I always try to do is safety, safety, safety. I know sometimes it doesn't look that way. I do wear shorts in the garage. I have a problem with wearing pants. I'm not sure what it is. It just could be just a mental thing. I don't know. Don't like pants. But I do wear gloves. I do wear a jacket, face shield. Most of the time I wear a do-rag because it gets hot on the nugget. Couple of the safety things. If you are welding in a closed area, like I was just welding inside the garage, there's wood chips, there's cardboard boxes, there's wood, there's a bunch of stuff in there that could catch fire. So on a safety tip, stick around for at least 30 minutes to 45 minutes and make sure nothing smokes. All right, make sure everything is cooled down, everything is safe to leave that area. Now I have to go to a beating later on this afternoon, so I'm gonna stick around for about 35, 45 minutes, clean up a little bit, and make sure the garage doesn't start on fire, because that would be really bad, because I wouldn't have any place to do the channel. So anyway, if you like it, subscribe. If you wanna see some more stuff, hit that bell, and I got plenty more stuff to actually get done. But this one here is a real quick, simple, easy way to haul really long stuff and hopefully not tear up my bed or my cab. So anyway, till next time, later.